Depends on page 355, when we come later. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Gloria begins on page 356. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Holy Lord, you alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Grant to us, Lord, we pray, the Spirit to think and do always those things that are right, that we who cannot exist without you, may by you be enabled to live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the lessons.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At Horeb, the Mount of God, Elisha came to a cave and spent the night there. Then the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "What are you doing here, Elisha?" He answered, "I have been very zealous for the Lord, the God of hosts. But the Israelites have forsaken your covenant, thrown down your altars, and killed your prophets with the sword. I alone am left, and they are seeking my life to take away." He
If it is you, command me to come to you on the water. He said, come. So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, Lord, save me! Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, you of little faith, why did you doubt? And they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped him, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Slowly, steadily, gently. I well know the ministry of law enforcement. I always say that my husband is the minister in the family. Not only many times he has rescued the lost and the fearful. We are all ministers. This police officer recognized his ministry. This man's safety was obviously dependent upon this police officer who had gained his trust. Had the officer turned loose the man's hand? Had he shouted impatiently at the man? Or had he tried to rush? The sense of trust would have been broken. The mission to get this marginalized man to safety would have been derailed. My mind went immediately to today's gospel lesson, this account of Peter being saved from sinking. Jesus reaching out his hand to save Peter from drowning. Again, as in this week's lesson, evening has come. We often read in the gospels of Jesus going to the other side, or sending the disciples to the other side, which is a signal to us of a transition. We just had encountered, as we read last week, the feeding of the 5,000. And now, once again, Jesus has sent the disciples away in their boat so that he can stay behind and have some time alone to pray. If the disciples have been sent to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, which is why, if you're trying to row across in a boat, and it is a place of frequent unexpected storms and high winds, because it's surrounded on one side by the Golden Heights, those high mountains. It's easy for storms to come up unexpectedly. So this is what has occurred in this night, just after the feeding of the 5,000. By early morning, the disciples have been struggling against the wind and waves all night long, and yet they're still far from shore, Matthew tells us. Far from shore, Jesus comes toward them walking on the water, and like Elijah, they are very much afraid, feeling alone and abandoned. They are afraid. Jesus comes toward them walking on the water. And amidst the fear and confusion, Peter, recognizing the Lord, gets out of the boat. The sea is raging, but Jesus does not calm the storm as Peter approaches. Jesus simply says, "Come." In spite of the storm, Jesus says, "Come." Peter comes toward Jesus walking on the water until, taking his eyes off Jesus, Peter notices the storm. He's distracted by the storm, and he begins to sink. Only through his faith and trust in Jesus can Peter walk on the water, alone, distracted by his fear, and without the recognition of his dependence on Jesus, Peter sinks. He cannot save himself or anyone else without this faith and trust. He must stay focused on Jesus. A simple message, a difficult message by which to live. He must stay focused on Jesus, even though the storm continues to rage. He must stay focused on Jesus. Peter could not save himself. Elijah could not save himself. The tall, lanky subject on the street corner on that early Sunday morning could not save himself. are dependent upon Jesus Christ. When we lose focus on that faith and trust, we flee in fear. We slip below the surface. We struggle aimlessly. We struggle until, in the silence, we hear the Lord's voice. What are you doing here? Just what do you think you're doing here? And we follow his command. Come. Stand in the body of Christ. Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed, which begins on page 358. We believe in one God, the Father,
the Lord, and Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God of God, light of light, true God from true God, God not made, of one being with the Father, through whom all things were made, for us, our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became the Father of one Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified by the conscious Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and Son and his worship, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge our baptism of the gift of forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace, we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are hard.
For Donald, our president, Ralph, our governor, Kenneth, our mayor, for this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, and justice, and oppression.
For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to this city, the heavens, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who obey the gospel, and all who seek the truth.
For Justin, the Archbishop in Clary, Michael, our presiding bishop, Susan, our bishop, Anne, our priest in charge, for our parish staff and volunteers, and for all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God and love the church.
For all on our parish prayer list whose names in our bulletin and others. We pray for all U.S. Armed Forces personnel, especially those serving in the war zones and their families. We pray for peace in the land of the Holy Land. We pray for victims of violence and terrorism in our nation and throughout the world, and all who have suffered dire effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. Hear us, Lord.
We are mercy and great.
We will exalt you, O God, our King.
And praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Remember in special manner the Holy Mary, in whose memory the altar flowers are given.
Dead.
Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
Who put Christ in you.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, O merciful Father, in your compassion to forgive us our sins.
No man or woman, take son and breath of thy love, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor to his name, great offering. Thanksgiving continues with Eucharistic Prayer A, which begins in your Book of Common Prayer on page 361. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, 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 God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed. when we have fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace, and at the last day bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thank you. all my heart, my soul, and my mind. Let nothing separate me from you. Let me serve you in this life until by your grace I come to your glorious kingdom and unending peace. Amen. In thanksgiving, let us pray. On page 365. 366.